Hi, this is Presh Talwalkar. Quadratic equations are extremely important in mathematics, but unfortunately, they can also be very confusing. In this video, I'm going to present a visual and geometric proof so that you understand the quadratic formula intuitively. Imagine you want to solve x squared plus 2x minus 15 equals 0. You could solve this by graphing the equation x squared plus 2x minus 15. The points at which the graph crosses the x-axis are the solutions. You could also solve this equation by factoring into linear terms. If you set these linear terms equal to 0, you'll get the same solutions as written in the graph. When those methods don't work, the quadratic formula will always tell you how you can solve any quadratic equation with arbitrary constants a, b, and c. So this is a very useful formula, but unfortunately, it's not often presented in an intuitive way. Why exactly does it work? So let's try and understand this geometrically. Let's solve this equation. First, we'll add 15 to both sides so that we have x squared plus 2x equals 15. I'll now color code each term. Each term is going to represent the area of a shape. For x squared, I'll represent it by a square which has a side length of x. The area of the square is equal to x squared. The term 2x I'll represent by a rectangle, which has a side length of 2 and another side length of x. The area of this rectangle is equal to 2x. Finally, the term 15 I'll represent by a rectangle, which has an area of 15. It doesn't matter what the exact side lengths are. It only matters that the area is 15, so I'm not going to write in the side lengths. But the task we have is we want to have the two shapes on the left, we want their areas to be equal to the area of 15, which is the shape on the right. So how can we do that? Well, the first thing we want to do is we want to combine the two shapes. And lucky for us, we have one common side of x. So we can combine these two shapes on one common side. But there's a trick we're going to use. We're going to split the rectangle of 2x into two small rectangles, which are x by 1. And now we're going to join these strips onto each side of the square. So now we have a shape that's almost equal to a square. So what we need to do is we want to add on the little area so that we get a square. So we put an orange rectangle here, and each of its side lengths is equal to 1, and so this area is equal to 1. And in order to balance the equation, we want to add the same area to the right-hand side. So what we've done geometrically will represent algebraically by adding a term of 1 to each the left and the right-hand sides of the equation. And this is what's known as completing the square. You've probably heard the term in algebra class, but this is the geometric reason. We're literally adding a term to this area so that we can complete a square. And now this helps us solve the problem, because what we want to do, we'll simplify that 15 plus 1 is equal to 16, is we have a square with a side length of x plus 1, and we need that square to be equal to the square on the right-hand side. So we want x plus 1 squared to have an area of 16. Now, one way we could do this to have an area of 16 is we could imagine having a square that has a side length of 4. So in order for our square on the left to be equal to the square on the right, we want x plus 1 to be equal to 4. We can easily solve this, that x is equal to 3. But there's another way that we can do this. It's kind of an unusual way, but imagine we had side lengths of negative 4. If we multiply negative 4 by itself, we also get an area of 16. So we could also set x plus 1 equal to negative 4. And that gives us our other solution of x equals negative 5. So this is the visual way to understand quadratic equations. And if you understood this, I'm going to show you this proof just in a more general way, which is how we get the quadratic formula. So we have a general quadratic equation, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract c from both sides. So we have ax squared plus bx equals negative c. We'll now divide by the constant term of a, so we have x squared plus b over ax equals negative c over a. This is very similar to the equation we just solved. It has x squared plus something times x equals a constant term. So let's use the same procedure. We'll represent x squared as being the area of a square with the side length of x. We'll represent b over a times x by a rectangle which has one side of b over a and another side of x. And we'll represent the term negative c over a by a rectangle which has an area of negative c over a. We don't need to write the length of the side, we just know that the area is negative c over a. So we want the area of the areas of the two shapes on the left to equal the area of the shape on the right. We'll use the same trick as in the last problem. We'll divide our middle green rectangle in half so that we have two side lengths of b over 2a. We'll now combine that with the square that has a side length of x by matching the side of x. And now we almost have a square. What we're missing is an orange square, and each of its side lengths is b divided by 2 over a. So b divided by 2 over a multiplied by itself gives us the area of the orange square, which is b squared divided by 4a squared. In order to balance the areas, we have to add the same area to the right-hand side. So now let's do this algebraically. We need to add b squared divided by 4a squared to both sides of the equation. We'll simplify the right-hand side of the equation. If we combine the two like terms, I'm going to skip a couple steps, but the right-hand side becomes b squared minus 4ac all over 4a squared. So that becomes the area of the rectangle on the right-hand side. The left-hand side, we have a square with a side length of x plus b over 2a. And we want that to be equal to our square, which has an area of b squared minus 4ac all over 4a squared. So there are two ways we could do this. We could set this equal to positive the square root or negative the square root of the area of the right-hand side. So we have our side length of the square on the left, x plus b over 2a, will either equal the positive root or it will equal the negative root. And now if we simplify the square root and then move the term b over 2a to the right-hand side, we end up with the quadratic formula that x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And that's where the quadratic formula comes from intuitively, is that this is the length that will allow the square on the left to be equal to the square on the right. So I hope this gives you a deeper understanding of the quadratic formula and its geometric interpretation. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar, and you can get my books. I've written many books about math and game theory. There are links in the video description.